Blessings be with us all, and you see. I shall see and rejoice. The Lord has sworn on Margaret, you are a priest forever after me, were about she said. The Lord is at your right hand, our saintly father, patriarch of Atoadrus, and our father, the metropolitan of Serapion, and our father, the bishop of Akirimpos. May the Lord keep your light.
Amen and
So he cited the verse that we heard today, that you you love your enemies, you turn the cheek when you are slapped on the cheek, as we heard last night in the gospel reading. It's complemented with today's gospel, how to do good, and those who ask from you, you give, and don't expect in return. So when he told them to turn the other cheek, the group said, we don't know how to do this. So he told them, okay, at least to endure patiently when someone afflicts you in this way. They said, we don't know how to do that either. So they said, at least then you don't fight back and retaliate in return. They said, we don't know how to do that either. So then he told the disciples, get them some soup, something to eat, because I have nothing else to do for them. They don't want to follow the gospel, so the only thing we do now is pray. This instruction and lesson from St. Anthony is very helpful for us. The gospel command, which as the Lord says in this gospel, one who is faithful and obedient, by the end result, he will be perfect like your Heavenly Father. But sometimes to reach perfection, and when we put the goal very clear for us, many of us may get discouraged and find it impossible. But when St. Anthony guides us in a way that at least we take the first mile in order to reach the second mile. What is the first mile? Which is how to be decent, kind to the people, that at the very least, as the Lord said, even the enemies, your enemies, the difficult people, they are at least kind to the people like them as well. If someone does good to them, they do good back. So maybe we can start. If someone does good to you, don't treat them in a negative way, in a rough way. Sometimes we will doubt the sincerity of people. We don't know if we can trust them. But at least to be kind, even to all other people. What happens when they don't treat us well? One time there was a priest who was going to serve from the monastery, and he was asking the advice of the elders. So one of the elders told the priest, he said, teach the people how to love one another. And what does that mean? He said that the people, sometimes we treat each other worse even than the animals. If you look at the animals, they have their own groups, especially monkeys or serpents, and they have their clan. And they will fight with each other sometimes over certain things. But sometimes, one level above that, which is to be human, we don't fight over unnecessary things, the regular human being. And then after that, how to be a decent human being. And then after a decent human being, how to be a good Christian. And that level, which we are called to be, is higher than any other person. One time there was a lady who was confessing, and she was complaining about someone at work, and how she was being mistreated. And it was affecting her life. Usually when you get upset at someone, and we have a certain type of disease where the person will keep repeating, not just in your mind, but all the people around you, and then it grows and becomes a big story. So this is what happened with the lady. So difficult, she went to confess. So Buddha told her, this lady that you are complaining about, is she Christian? He said, no, she's not Christian. So she's not baptized, he answered. No, she's not baptized. So she doesn't read the Bible. She said, no, Buddha, she's not Christian. And she doesn't come to the church and take communion and listen to the sermons like you listen to the sermons, and read from the saints' stories and have the example of the saints, have the icons to help them and the guardian angel. After Buddha continued, she understood. All of the things that we have, the people of the world don't have. And so our standard is much higher. That's why it says we will be judged with a much higher standard than the others. They don't know. And even if they know, there are some people who left. The way that the church cares for us is above. Sometimes we think and we see, how much did God love us that we didn't ask to be Christian, we didn't ask to be baptized, we didn't ask for a church to be established. Some of the people will ask, but even when His Holiness spoke through the Son, the first priest, to a mirror. We didn't ask. It wasn't upon request. There was the need and it was sent. Or even in the time when His Holiness spoke, Shenouda sent Hamasrepi for us to be our beloved shepherd. It wasn't out of request. There's a different story behind it for another time. But when you look at the best things that we have, it wasn't upon request that God loved and gave us this. And so those who don't, for us to be moved with compassion. Yesterday's gospel reading, we heard that the Lord Jesus Christ, when He saw the multitudes, He was moved with compassion. After He healed the sick and He comforted them and He the lame and the maimed and all of the needy. After He did all this, He said He was moved to compassion because they were a flock without a shepherd. And so He told them to send out laborers into the harvest. And this petition reminds us that the Lord is always looking at us more compassion, more loving, seeing the needs greater than what we see. And when we look at the others, we hope that we can see them in the way that God sees them, not in the earthly way. This needs a different vision for the people that are afflicted. Like, as one of the fathers said, the people who may attack us, and you know, the older that you get, they increase in number and in intensity. And if you pray for the people who are attack you, you find, yes, God will change the heart, but sometimes the attacks may increase. And that's what the Lord's promised to the disciples. They will do this to you. If you are a true Christian, they will do this to you. One of the famous sayings of Guru Trikamak, he said, if you start a service and there's no difficulty, there's no challenge, there's no attacks, then know that you're not going in the right direction. But when we are moving in the right direction, there will be things that come to attack. And there will be people that move against us. But the people who work against us, it's not always of their own volition, of their own will, but they are like a stick which Satan uses against us. And sometimes even the stick that is used to fight us breaks. So it is not for us, when we look at the people, we also to be moved with compassion. At least, or as St. Anthony says, at least that we can be patient and endure patiently and pray for those who ask us. There was once another lady, they were doing some organization in the church, and one of the servants was telling her when to stand, where to sit, but she was a little rough. So she got upset with herself, and she went to confess to Abuna before taking communion. And Abuna told her, he said, did you these thoughts that you have for her, did you pray for her? He said, no. Did you do Matanya for her? He said, no, the same questions. So he told her, it was very firm. He said, no communion for 2 months. So she got very surprised. So she said, Abuna, I couldn't stand. She wanted to give an excuse, but she said, he said, and I need you to pray in every prayer for her. Every time you come to pray the psalm and the Hebrew, every time you do say Kiriya Laison for you and her. So in the beginning, when she's doing the prayers, she's very frustrated. She doesn't want to say her name or see her face, but she has to be obedient, so she is praying for her sister. And after a while, even when she comes, she was able to come to the church, the time passed, she didn't find her Lily. And after a month, when she was praying for her, her heart began to change. She began to really feel the guilt of her judging her sister. And she wanted instead, when you pray for someone, this, well, your heart becomes united to them in the mystery of God, of the Spirit of love. And so through the prayer, when she came and returned to the church, she didn't find her, she asked, where is so-and-so that went to come and help? She said she had an accident and she did an operation, so she's at home. She said, if I heard this when a month ago, 2 months ago, she said, yes, God had done to her what was just. But when she realized she was moved with compassion, went to visit her and apologized to her, and they became very close friends. The work of love, which begins primarily with prayer, that's why St. Anthony concluded and said, when we find ourselves unable to fulfill what the scripture says, we must be moved to pray. Pray because our heart is cold, our heart is hardened, or we are lukewarm, or perhaps sometimes we are upset with other people because we see in them our own faults, reminds us of our own weakness, and it's difficult for us to forgive or to overlook. We want to hold it against them. Or as one of the priests said, sometimes we even move to judge other people so quickly, the only thing left is for us to tell Christ, come down from the throne so I can go and judge the people. This person is doing this wrong, this person is not treating me properly, and I can make accusation very good against many people and how they looked at me and what they said to this person and how come they didn't help me. And I gave them all of these things and this is the way they treated me. I could, if I want to be a judge, to be a judge. But if I want to be a Christian, I don't have the permission, as the Lord said, to be a judge. Even in the priesthood, yes, we have the instruction how to judge between right and wrong, to discern. But when it's something personal, even against us, that we don't have that same authority, as we must follow the gospel, how to be obedient, how to humble herself and to accept whatever that it comes to us. We accept patiently, and yes, is it difficult? This is what is carrying the cross, when the Lord Jesus Christ carried the cross, and we share in his afflictions in a very small way. I don't know if any of you have someone spit at you or call names at you or afflict you or whip you. Probably not. But when you feel as if someone did that to you, then the first step is to go to the one who witnessed all of that and was completely innocent. Sometimes we're innocent, we think ourselves completely innocent, but we do have some guilt. And when we look and turn to the Lord, then we find ourselves we're able to accept what is wrong and to see what is good. We are living in a world, especially after COVID, nobody has patience for anyone else. And the sensitivities are very high. Everyone more sensitive than they were in 2019. And more aggressive. It needs for the Christians to have a level of love and patience and compassion that is even beyond. And how are we going to approach this? Only in the fullness of love, to carrying our cross, and to witness to the gospel in what the world needs, instead of war and division and anger, to have peace, reconciliation, and purity. May the Lord bless us with every spiritual blessing, Lord, between now and every day.
Amen. Jesus, For you are good and righteous in mercy for all those who call upon your holy name. For you are powerful along with your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, to the age of all ages.
May the grace which perfects what we have caused by our weakness through your good will, O God, the Father, and the Holy Spirit, dwell on the Son, whose name has been mentioned for this rank of subdivision in the Holy Church of God, which was saved for the hardship and tribulations. Let's all ask for the Holy Spirit to come upon him by praying, Lord, have mercy.
Amen.
Joseph, and the reader in the Church of God. Amen.
Praise. You establish praise in your holy church, and your people worship you with songs, chants, and spirit.
spiritual souls, we ask you, Lord, to give your grace to your servants, that they may do the work of salvation in your holy church. And we sing unto you hymns, chants, and spiritual songs from their hearts to the Lord. To the grace, compassion, love of mankind, and only God, Son of God, and Savior, Jesus Christ, now and ever to be, to all ages. Amen.
Jesus,
Christ,
those
control.
Amen.
Thank you. mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Hail, Lord, Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, hear us and have mercy upon us. Offer, offer, offer in order. Stand with trembling, look toward the east, let us attend.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Saint Mary, O Lord, grant us the forgiveness of our sins. We worship you, O Christ, through your good Father, and the Holy Spirit, for you have risen and saved us. The mercy of peace, a sacrifice of praise.
Lord, with you
and with your spirit,
and the time so long shall I live on my generation and the way I can grow. in remembrance of me.
Amen.
Amen.
peace on Holy Catholic Church.
Lord have mercy.
Jesus Christ, who sent the blessed of the blue cross, have peace with all the loves which love, for Muslim abroad, patriarch of Abba Father the Second, and his father the Second, Ambassador of the Bishop Quinton, and Abba Kirill of the
give them all the heavenly Thank you. Amen.
Yeah.
Being of the sacrifice, I am the highest of the supreme first before the Lord, that he never mercy against our sins, let us pray.
Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, the good old Lord meant. Amen, amen, amen.
Oh. Thank you.